increase. Hallelujah. Let the character of Christ increase and my character decrease. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Bijabaruka
wholesomeness, Lord God. You send your Holy Spirit, the Spirit without measure, hallelujah, so that, Lord, I can become like you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, the same Spirit that helped Jesus to flee temptation, the same Spirit that ministered to Jesus in the time of his need. Hallelujah. The fullness of Lord, the Holy Spirit is what we ask this evening, Lord God. Help us, Lord, so that we can follow into your footsteps, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. If you've come here tonight thinking, hallelujah, what am I going to do for the next phase of my life? I want to tell you the best thing you can do is raise your hallelujahs. Hallelujah. If you are stuck, raise your hallelujah. If you feel that the battle is too big before you, raise your hallelujah. Because worship defeats the devil. Hallelujah. Martin Luther said, come, let us sing a psalm and defeat the devil. Hallelujah. Let us raise our hallelujahs. Thank you, Lord.
I raise a hallelujah.
Unfiltered, you know, don't worry about it. My mic is off. It's still loud, eh? My mic is on. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Yes. Awesome. Hello? Haji? Hello? 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 Awesome? Right? Okay. Can you hear me? Okay. All right. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
Okay. Praise God. Some, like, come on. Like, social. Okay. So,
yes.
Woo! Hallelujah. Praise God. Awesome. super excited, pump, what else they call it? Stoked, isn't it? Not going to say dope. All the words that I can see, isn't it? Praise God. Hallelujah. And so thrilled with you. So before I go there, first time campers. Raise up. Stand up, please. All right, somebody welcome them. All right, Calvin, Sheetal, Janice, Parita, and Rhea. You know, she just came yesterday night, okay? All right, so praise God. This is what we do when newcomers come, isn't it? We drag them to the church. So welcome, praise God, be here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. I know, I just want to tell you, you know, praise God, it requires the wisdom of God for $120 to get 4 breakfasts, 4 lunches, and 3 dinners, and 3 nights, and 4 days stay. Isn't it? It requires wisdom of God. So how about thank you for Rashmi Bhai and Shailesh Bhai. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm just saying you can do the math, isn't it? Like, it's just impossible, isn't it? But that's how God's math is, isn't it? Praise God, you know, the choir team, the worship team, the media team, you know, you see how the hard work they have done just to set this up so that we can have the best of the experience. So praise God, Shelef and team, awesome. Are you expecting something?
Yes.
Hallelujah, praise God. I'm for sure expecting, I'm expecting this, that God will show up mightily. I'm expecting that the powerful manifestation of the Holy Spirit will be here. I'm expecting that the life will be changed, surrendered, and completely transformed for the glory of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. If you know, if you did notice your pen, just grab your pen and just, yeah. It says grow on it. Is it? If you see notepad, it says grow, you know, grow on it. You just can't, you know, we're just not going to give you any opportunity to think of the way around. Isn't it? We take every opportunity to write down. You know, we are here to, everybody say,
grow.
Okay, we are here to grow, and we call this Camp Grow, isn't it? And this is not just some, you know, marketing tactic to just come up with a hip name, but we were praying, and God gave this purpose into my heart, and we shared, and we talked, and we prayed, and he said, you know, this is the right way to go, because that's what God is laying on our heart. So some of the things would be new, some of the things would be old, but it doesn't matter where we are. Let me tell you, either we can be very mature Christians or we can be baby Christians. Completely fine, both of it. There is always room to grow. So it's not that this is not for me, this is for somebody. This is not for me because I got white beard in my white hair, my beard, I'm done with it. It's for me and it's for you. It's for each one of us. Hallelujah, isn't it? Somebody say, I'm here to grow. Tell your neighbor, I'm here to grow. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to just launch right into it. We are a little bit behind in the schedule, but we are okay with that. You know, like I'm saying, like, you know, like, watch was invented in the hell. That's what I think. Isn't it? Like, isn't it? All right. Since 2019, the things have dramatically changed in the physical world. But I also believe there's a tectonic plates being shifted into the spiritual world. Isn't it? I always hear two kinds of stories. The one story is there are overcomers who have overcome whatever season was thrown at them and they have come out victorious. But at the same time, the sad part is I've seen people fallen through cracks because it was 2019. And I think this moment is very exciting moment for the church of God on this planet Earth. And I want to tell you, you know, it seems like, you know, like we started with COVID and then, you know, we didn't even know, you know, it was before it was a coronavirus, isn't it? So if you say COVID, people think, oh my goodness, this is like some sort of a genius guy is talking COVID, isn't it? Now we got with few variants and then vaccine, all those things happening right now, and we think enemy has prevailed. Demonic agendas of vaccines have prevailed. But let me tell you, hallelujah, last time I checked, God is still sitting on the throne. Hallelujah. His calendar has not changed. Hallelujah. His blessing for his people has not changed. And his plan for you, somebody say plan for me, is not changed. No matter what has happened there, his plan for me has not changed. And I'm praying that in this camp, hallelujah, God will propel you. You know, I used to watch races before, car races. And if they're racing, and you know, there's something called nitro boosters. If you have not watched the car race, at least you have played a video game, isn't it? And then you know that now you have to run, and you put a nitro on, and the nitro structure gives you boost, and you run fast. This camp, God wants to put nitro booster in all of us. He will propel us to go where he wants us to go. It's like that, you know, you're running a race, but then there's a phase come that you kind of stall and you get tired and you get weary. Anybody? I'm the only one. You don't get tired, right? Isn't it? You don't say, just Christian walk is hard. Isn't it? Serving is hard. Isn't it? Shalev says, oh my goodness, media team is hard. Isn't it? Like, we all do that. This camp, what does it do? The camp, hallelujah, not only just brings you out of that tiredness and just burdensomeness, but it gives you a boost. Boost, not just to go next day or next month, but to go next year, isn't it? Praise God. So rest of the 2020, when I can promise it will be a blessed year because we are getting boosted by the power of the Holy Spirit right now here. And that's what the purpose of God is here. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I have many things to talk. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Grow, isn't it? Praise God. But at the same time, camp is a time of fun, so we don't ever forget that, okay? Right? Are we there? Are we here to have some fun?
Yes.
Okay, let me just pick on somebody, okay? I'm gonna pick on. Kelvin, what's your name? Jacob. Okay, tell me something about Jacob, man. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Lovely. Is that it? Praise God. I'm trying to find where is your well, okay? We'll figure it out. Jacob's well, okay? Awesome. So we're gonna have some fun, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. I have one question for all of you. Who was the fastest runner in the Bible? Are you sure? Okay. I want to say Adam was the fastest runner. You know why? He was the first in the human race. Okay. You want to hear another one? Okay, that's it. So we're going home, Pastor. Who was the first tennis player in the Bible? Bible says Joseph served in Pharaoh's courts. All right, that's it. Enough. Okay, all right, praise God. Thank you. Joseph served in Pharaoh's court. Okay, all right, so today is the first session. Session number one is grow up in Christ. Everybody say grow up in Christ. That's the theme of this camp, and this is going to be introductory message. This message is very, 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 very important. That's why we are sharing this on our Praise Bible Church group, so those who are coming tomorrow can watch it. This session is important for other sessions to follow. So this is kind of a building block. This is something that you can step upon and move forward with. So I would say pay attention. I know we are a little bit late in the day, but you know, who cares, isn't it? Praise God. So somebody say, grow up in Christ. Hallelujah. This is coming from Ephesians chapter 4, verse 15, but we're going to go there. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I'm going to give you 5 points. Hallelujah. First point, first statement that I want to give it to you. No points. Number one statement. Hallelujah. Praise God. Growing is will of God. Somebody say growing is the will of God. You grow, that is will of God the Father. Are we there? It was not your plan that you came up with that, you know, I want to grow. It is Lord, the Holy Spirit, birth that righteous desire within you. That's why you're saying that I want to grow. You know, it is the desire of your daddy. Your father wants that you grow, and I would grow, isn't it? Sometimes when we tell people, you know, you need to grow, they say, oh my goodness, you get offended, isn't it? But I want to tell you, as a generally, growing up is the will of God for your life, isn't it? Praise God. Sometimes when you are primary stages of our life and we say, I don't know what is God's will for me, I want to tell you, number one thing, God's will that you would grow. God's will is that you would? Somebody say, I will grow. Okay, let's read Ephesians 4, verse 15. We can have some of the verses here, praise God. And it says, rather speaking the truth in love, it says, we are to grow. We are to grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Jesus Christ, isn't it? NKJV translation, but speaking the truth in love may grow up in all things into him who is the head in Christ. We are not just growing up physically, but we are growing up in Jesus Christ. Isn't it? There's some sort of a standard that we are measured against. Not in a bad sense, but I'm saying there's something to look forward to. Where are you growing? Or where are you growing to? Somebody saying, you know, I want to grow to become this and that. God says we are growing up in Christ. Everybody say, grow up in Christ. Okay, praise God. Be with me. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, praise God. There's a theme in the Bible about growth, isn't it? We're going to have a next, can we have next verse, please? So 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse number 6 says, hallelujah, praise God. I planted, Apollos water, but God gave the growth. Isn't it? H is missing. It's my mistake. Isn't it? God gave the growth. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Another next verse. Hallelujah. Psalm 92 verse number 12. The righteous thrive like a palm tree and grow like cedars in Lebanon. Hallelujah. Cedar tree never stops growing. That's why they are the tallest tree in the world. Isn't it? Are we there? Okay, praise God. Are you convinced that we need to grow? It's okay, all right. That's good. Do we have anything else? All right, Philippians 1:9. And I pray this. So Paul is praying for the Philippian church. He says, I pray for all of you that your love will keep on growing in knowledge and every kind of discernment. He says, I want your love to grow. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I think we have one more verse, I guess. Do we have it? No? No? Okay. All right, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We have more slides though, right? Okay, praise God. I said, okay, well, mistakes. All right, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. What is growth? Growth is a dynamic process. Isn't it? Growth means ever-changing process. Hallelujah, praise God. But to grow, first thing is that, hallelujah, praise God, are you eligible to grow? Hallelujah. Let me tell you who can grow. Are you born again, child in the kingdom of God? That's the number one thing. Then you start growing, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I was reading this post, and there's this demonic heretics that talks about it, that if you are, you know, whatever, I'm just not even mentioned that. But people say, oh, I'm born this way. Isn't it? Have you heard that?
Yes.
I'm born this way. But I say, yeah, you're born this way, but that's why you need to be born. That's why you're not born this way, you're born in God's way. Isn't it? Praise God. So if you're born again, that's the first step of your growth. Hallelujah. If you're not born again, I would highly encourage you to give your life to Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And He gives you new heart. He gives you new mind. He gives you new desire so that we may grow. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. We have some more slides. All right. Okay. So what is growing? Let me come here. Okay. Growing is not growing in head knowledge, but growing in revelation. Somebody say revelation.
Revelation.
You see? God is a God of revelation. There are things that are hidden that He opens it for us. You see? The Bible you read every day, every year you've been reading, but God says, you know, you come to the passage, God says, something new. You see? Now you're growing in revelation. So growing is growing in revelation. Hallelujah. Praise God. Growing is not holding higher positions, but sending souls to highest heavens. Somebody agree with me?
Yes.
Somebody say, you progress well, you've grown well. I say growing is not holding higher positions, but sending souls to the highest heavens. You know, Apostle Paul became apostle, but he still kept saving souls wherever he go. Before he was serving souls in the street, then he was serving souls in the palaces. But he was still saving souls. Amen? Are we there? Somehow we have an idea that, you know, Pelu, street work is lower work, and then you come to the church work, and then the committee work, and then the bishop. It's not like that. Growing up, that we are sending more and more and more souls to heaven. Amen? Praise God. Growing is not to have a reputation in the society. Okay? Are we there? But have a servanthood in kingdom of God. Have a servanthood in the kingdom of God. Isn't it? I was watching a speech of a valedictorian, and I made Joshua watch it. And this father said to this son, he says, make sure your servant towel is always bigger than your ego. You know the towel that servant ties around the vest? He said, make sure your servant towel is bigger than your ego. Servant towel is bigger. So growing up, are you serving more? Are you servant more? Are you humble more? That is growing more. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. Somehow we think growing up is just give orders. That's not growing, is it? Growing is more serving. Growing is not being in the limelight. Not floodlights on you, but having the light of Jesus brighter in and through you. Yeah, light of Jesus shine brighter through you and in you. Growing is not adding years to your faith, but adding influence. We are through your faith, adding influence through your faith. Are you influencing? Isn't it? No, and nothing wrong with saying that, you know, kyun prabhu ni paad atla varsho di jao. Nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying, isn't it? But I'm just saying growing is more than that. Then you know what? હું પ્રભુની પાસે આટલા વર્ષોથી ચાલું છું અને આટલા લોકોને હું ઇન્ફ્લુએન્સ કરું છું, આટલાને હું મેન્ટર કરું છું, આટલાને હું ડિસાઇપલ કરું છું, આટલાને હું સુવાર્તા આપું છું, આટલાને હું વોટ એવર પ્રિપેર કરું, વોટ એવર આઈ એમ ડુઈંગ, દેટ ઇઝ વોટ ગ્રોઈંગ ઇઝ. આર વી હિયર? ઓકે, પ્રેઇઝ ગોડ, થેન્ક. દેટ ઇઝ વોટ ગ્રોઈંગ લુક્સ લાઈક. હાલેલુયા. સો નંબર વન થિંગ, ગ્રોઈંગ અપ ઇઝ અ વિલ ઓફ ગોડ. જસ્ટ બી વિથ મી. સમટાઈમ્સ વી થિંક ગ્રોઈંગ અપ ઇઝ from jeans, t-shirt to shirt and pants. That's not growing up, okay? Are we there? Growing up is not being uptight and act like that you're grown up. Are we there? Isn't it? Like, growing up is not just, you know, like three-piece suit, pen and always phone. That's not growing up. Jesus says, I think in Mark chapter 4, 10, verse number 15. Let's read Mark 10, 15. Do we have it? He says, "Assuredly I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of Lord as a little child, nana balak ni jem devra je devna janu hriday nana balak jevu ne te devna rajyama pravesh karse nahi. So I want to tell you, grow up but stay young. Grow up but stay young, isn't it? Have the, let me tell you, growing up never replaces childlike faith in the kingdom of God. Isn't it? Jesus says, become like children. Isn't it? Not here, but here, isn't it? You know, there are parents here. Parents, would you agree with me? Isn't it? Praise God. You can tell them and they'll believe you. You know why they'll believe you? Because you have said it. Are we there? Because you have said it. Even though it is not right, they will believe it. God says, be like a child, believe the word like a child, act in a faith like a child, but yet grow up. Amen. Praise God. So number one thing that I told you, hallelujah, praise God, is growing is a theme of, growing is a will of God. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Second thing, now you think, so we're going to, this is how the format is going to be. We're going to start, then at times we're going to go a little bit deep, and then we're going to kind of have an application, something like that, okay? Praise God. So second point. Everybody read it for me, please. Growing is automatically kasuni thai jai, isn't it? Like, it's not gonna, like, switch turn on, I'm growing. It's not gonna happen. Horlicks boost doesn't work here, isn't it? Like, you know, I know. You know, India will grow tonic per piuda, you know? They will talk grow. Calcium ni godiyo ketla hai khadi. Sandos na dabba apana khawdawa maata tha, ke they will grow, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So number one, I want to tell you, hallelujah, praise God. Number one, I tell you, growing is a personal commitment. It is a personal. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse number 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse number 11. Isn't it? This is Paul is saying, okay? Paul says, when I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child, which is okay. But when I grew up, somebody say, when I grew up. What did he do? I put away childish things. I put away. Okay, are we there? Are we listening to what Paul is saying? Isn't it? Praise God. Paul says, I used to reason like a child. Isn't it? I came and I became a baby Christian. You know, I would have debate. You know, I talked to people and I was just, my talk was like a child. And he says, now I have grown. And you know, my childish thing, I have put it behind. Childish thing, put it behind. It's a personal commitment to put behind childish things. Are we there? Praise God. It means if you're 5 years before you're born again, 5 years pehla prabhu ne jeevan saampyu, now you are there. Are we having the same struggle as 5 years before? Are we having the same challenges of the habits 5 years before? Are we still trying to overcome the demons that we were supposed to be overcoming 5 years before? Isn't it? I want to tell you, Paul says, I have put away those things. Isn't it? The personal commitment, isn't it? Praise God. Before we get something, we're going to put off something, isn't it? So personal commitment is, we're going to put away the old things. Childish thing, childish habits, childish thought process, childish discussion, childish desire, hallelujah. We're going to put away the childish thing and then we will grow. Hallelujah. Somebody want to make that commitment, isn't it? Yes, we're going to put away the childish thing. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Put away childish thing. Put away childish things. It's funny. You know, sometimes we, you know, we pray, Lord, I want to grow. I say, Lord, cause me to grow. But sometimes we are not able to put that effort into our lives. Isn't it? I just want to give you one thing. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So, Do we have John chapter 5 here? Let's see. All right. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So we know this example. Is this miracle Jesus performed at the pool of Siloam. Isn't it? Very well done in Chosen, isn't it? Isn't it? Jesse, isn't it? Praise God. So Jesus talked to this guy, and Jesus says, what did Jesus say? Rise. Okay, rise. Rise is in Jesus' hand. Jesus said, I'm going to heal you. Okay? Okay, rise is fine. Okay, that's healing. But there's a second thing Jesus said. Take up your bed and walk. We think this is a whole miracle. But I think the miracle is rise. Miracle is rise. Means I've said it, you get up. That's it. So you're healed. Now once you're healed, what do? Once you're healed, take up your mat and walk. Okay, can I? I'm just going to, you know, I'm going to regret this, you know, but I'm still going to do it. Okay. I'm not sure he didn't have this kind of a chadar, but just say. So this guy is on the pool of Siloam for how many years? Anybody remember? 38 years. Okay, I'm trying. Oh, I need help. Okay. 38 years he's sitting like this. Isn't it? And Jesus says, do you want to get well? He says, I want to, but there's nobody to help me. Isn't it? Be with me. 38 years. If he would have moved quarter of an inch every day, one centimeter move thought every day. If he would have moved 1 centimeter every day, he would have reached the pool of Siloam. Are you there? Are you listening to me? Isn't it? I know he's paralyzed, but at least you can just vibrate your body and move a little bit. Isn't it? A little bit. Isn't it? If he would have done it, he would have reached the pool of Siloam. Are you listening? Does it make sense to you? Isn't it? Praise God. It is grace of God that Jesus came and healed him there. Isn't it? But let me tell you, his conditional, the reason that he says, nobody's there to pick me up. You know, the mistake that we made, that we give the responsibility to somebody else for our growth. Are you there? Pastor is not teaching good enough. Bible study is not good enough. That's why there's a lot of people don't show up, isn't it? Look, anyways. Prayer meeting is not good enough. Youth group is not good enough. You know, right? I'm just saying why we give responsibility of our growth to somebody else. Isn't it? Like each would have a calling. They all have a job to do. But growing up is your personal commitment. Be with me. How important it is. If we don't take that personal commitment, 38 years. Imagine. 38 years, you're sitting in a pool of Siloam, maybe 10 feet away. You see people getting healed. You can see people getting walk up. You see people getting blessed. And you're sitting there for 38 years, not willing to get blessed because you're not moving an inch. First day of the camp. I shouldn't do this to you guys, okay? First day of the camp. The guy did not move an inch. If he moved an inch 38 years, you know, he would have reached, you know, Jerusalem. You know, I'm just saying, by dragging himself. So number one thing I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, that we got to move. We got to move from where we are. You know, growth is a progressive thing, and growth is a measurable thing. So, you know, I want you to do that exercise when you go to bed or tonight. You know, just see, take inventory of yourself. That God, where am I right now? You say, I come to your camp next year. You know, have I grown there? Or you take inventory of yourself for the last year. COVID started. You know, this is COVID season. Everything is made by COVID. 2019, when COVID started, where I was spiritually. Where my thought process was, where my Bible reading was, where my worship was, where my heart for saving souls was. You know, where was I? Have I grown? I'm leaving that to you. Even though it is Jesus to bring you to the destination, but you can at least move. Can we do that? Isn't it? We can at least move. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. Second thing I want to say to you. You know, I didn't plan this. Maybe he didn't move because it was more comfortable to lying down than to give some strength and move a little bit. Was it? It would have taken some pain to move himself because he's paralyzed. He would have to kind of put some energy from somewhere and try to push himself, kick against. Something has to be done. So was it more comfortable for him lying on a mat for 38 years? I just want to give you a picture of this. You know what comfort does to us? Comfort does this. 38 years, guy's still sitting there. Still sitting there. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. This, as I said, God want to propel you into your next season, isn't it? Praise God. And that's why we are making this commitment that we are gonna grow. Hallelujah. Praise God. We are gonna grow. Hallelujah. Praise God. And next thing Jesus does, rise up, and then Jesus says, take up your mat. Okay, be with me. Take up your mat and walk. You're lying there. My job. Can't do anything, my job. Jesus said, take it up. Pick it up. Start walking. You know, my family situation is such that, Pastor, you don't understand. Pick up that mat. Family situation, pick it up and walk. You know, you don't know that. You know, I didn't have a good pastor like you. Thank you, but no thank you. You see? Pick that up, mat. Your growth is not dependent on your pastor. You're not going to bank it on your pastor. You're going to bank it on Jesus and yourself, isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. So take that mat up. Pastor, you know, India, my Rahu. You're not in India anymore. Pick it up. Pick it up and walk. All I want to say is, whatever excuses, pardon me, whatever things we are thinking that we did not grow. Pastor, I love food. And when I eat, I can't read my Bible. Then, pick it up the mat. Something Bible says, fasting and praying. Do that. Isn't it? Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Pick up your mat and walk. Somebody say, I'm going to pick up my mat. I'm going to walk. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Pick up your mat and walk. Pick up your mat and walk. Pick up your mat and walk. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. One more thing I'm going to say before I go to the third point. Hallelujah, praise God. You know, praise God. Thank you. Commitment and non-commitment. In between, there's a big chasm. Commitment and non-commitment is a big chasm. And that chasm is called procrastination. Prolonging thing. Kya karisu? Kya karisu? You see? Tomorrow never dies, good with James Bond, but not for us. Tomorrow never comes. Tomorrow? Never come. Come on, we are Gujarati. You know, we go to the stationery store and they are board maral boy, mutu board. Board parsu lakhil boy, aje rokda. Kal never comes. I'm going to read Bible from tomorrow. Tomorrow is not coming. You're going to start doing it from? Somebody said today. Today. You say, I'm going to change when these things happen. Let me tell you, things will not happen. Will you not going to change? Today we're going to change. Hallelujah. Praise God. One author said this way. He says, procrastination is not a thief of time, but thief of souls. People have not grown and not closer to God just because they were putting it for tomorrow. They were putting it for tomorrow. You know, some people say, you know, maybe I know that I'm convicted a little bit, but not enough convicted. I'm like, yeah, Pavitra, I'm going to say, but I didn't feel strong that I want to do it. I want to tell you something very important and very practical and very real. Conviction that you feel today, je Pavitra Atmano vaj tamne atyara feel thi raho chhe. If you don't act on it, let me know, the next conviction will not be stronger. It would be, in fact, weaker conviction. So you're thinking of, kya ba anti vadhare strong feel thai nuh kao. Let me tell you, you're going to only feel weaker conviction and a weaker conviction and a weaker conviction, and you and I will never act on it. Are we there? You know, and that is why there's a message of gospel, preach, and people never come to Lord Jesus Christ. Some people, I say, because they know that I have to come, but I will go when? Tomorrow. Let me know, tomorrow never came, hallelujah. I give you one example. You know, Felix is not here, you know, but let so we can talk about him, isn't it? Right? Acts. This is old. This pastor is saying, okay, Acts 24, don't make this clip, huh? Okay. Acts 24, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So, these three verses, 24 times, you can mark it. I just want to tell you quickly what happens. So, Philip is a king, you see? And he has a wife called? Drusilla. Is anybody named Drusilla here? No? Oh, Drusilla? No, you're Priscilla. Drusilla, Priscilla, Tryphena, Tryphosa. There's so many names, okay? Okay, so his wife named Drusilla. And when Paul was in prison in Rome, Philip would come. And Philip would, Felix would come. And Felix says, Paul, talk about Jesus. Talk about Jesus. Because Felix wanted to hear about Jesus. Okay? So he said, he sent for Paul and heard concerning the faith in Christ. Verse number 10. As he reasoned about the righteousness, self-control, judgment to come, Felix was afraid and answered, "Go away for now when I have convenient time." Does it sound like you? Does it sound like me? When I have convenient season in my life, I will do this. When I have convenient occasion, then I will do it. When I have convenient pocket, then I will do it. It won't be convenient. Meanwhile, he hoped the money would be given. What happened? After 2 years, Porcus Festus succeeded Felix. He was doing this for 2 years. Then you know what? I will listen more about Jesus tomorrow. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. For 2 years, tomorrow never came. We don't know what happened to Felix. But he had opportunity to hear the gospel from the mouth of Apostle Paul. Yet he did not respond to it because, let me tell you, there was only procrastination. So it is not about who is preaching the gospel, because Paul is preaching here. But yet Felix did not receive him because there was a lack of commitment to do it today. He said, say with me, I'm going to do it today. Okay, we're going to do it today. Isn't it? We're going to do it today. We're going to make the change. Samuel is in the house. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Your prophets are in the house. Awesome. 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 We're going to wait for prophetic words. So now prophets have started coming anyways. Praise God. Awesome. Awesome. So second point that I want to give you. Hallelujah. Say with me. Hallelujah. That growing is personal commitment. Hallelujah. Praise God. Third thing. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. Third point. That's okay. Growing up requires, somebody say planting. We are wonderful people who know how to plant here. And we can start our own greenhouse, isn't it? Right in Praise Bible Church greenhouse. The highest export would be Kerala, isn't it? Like, and Dudi. And Dudi. Oh my. All right. Tomato is going to freezer, but Kerala, you to eat it. And Dudi, you to eat it. Is it? One weekend I end up with three this big doodi. One same weekend. Is it? So to come up with so many recipes to process that food, isn't it? But praise God. You know? But it's so simple, isn't it? You must have remembered, you know, either you have planted a seed in February or March, is it? And then now you're yielding the fruits from the same tree. I still remember, you know, we had this small trays and we put the seeds from the tomatoes. And you see the small sprout coming out, which was like maybe like 1 millimeter, 2 millimeters. Oh my goodness, it's coming up. And now there are tomatoes everywhere. You see? Growing up requires planting. Somebody say growing up requires planting. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Psalm chapter 1, verse number 3. Psalm chapter verse 1. He shall be like a tree. Somebody say planted.
Planted.
Hallelujah, praise God. Which tree will grow? The tree that is planted. Which tree will grow? The tree that is
planted.
Tree that is planted, that tree will grow. To grow, you need to be planted. I need to be planted. I can grow in love with my wife because I'm planted with my wife. Isn't it? Are we there? Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let's see what do we have next slide. Okay. All right. No science class. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you. But this is what a germination looks like. Isn't it? Okay, you know, a seed is planted, bijne vavama yu chhe, isn't it? And it remains under the soil. It remains under the soil, isn't it? It remains under the soil and it goes through. You know, if you put it under the soil, you don't even know what is happening. Are you there? There are seasons in the life you don't know what is happening because you are buried. You know, to put under the soil has two words. Buried and planted. Are you there? But both have a different result. Isn't it? Buried, there is no life in it. That's why it decays. But when you plant something, the life of Lord Jesus Christ in it, that's why it grows. Amen? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So when you plant something, thank you, Jesus. People think, what is happening? Am I like stuck at the same place? No. Stuck at the same place. I'm planted. I'm growing. I'm germinating. You know, God. And what happens to the seed? The seeds remove outer cells. And jo bahar nu pad che tuti jaye. Is that? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. To germinate a seed, that shell has to be broken. Otherwise, the shoot will not come out. Are we there? Have you seen that? You know, have you seen it? Like, you know, like if you, bhaji, we are growing everywhere, man. Isn't it? Like, have you seen methi? Oh my goodness, okay. But methi is still okay, isn't it? But karela. just joking. Okay, praise God. The seed has to be broken and then it grows and germinates. Are you there? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I want to tell something to you guys. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, you will be made fun of. That what is that church? Sucha dost. What is it? Every weekend church? Saturday, Sunday church? Baki to Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday be church. Isn't it? You can say, you know, I am being planted right now. I am being planted. You don't see me outside, but God is doing many things inside me. You know, I am growing. I am receiving. I am getting nourishment. And I'm my outer shell is being removed. The old self is being removed. My old habits are being removed. And I am ready to germinate. And when I germinate, my Bible says, I will be like a big tree. I'll be like a tree planted by rivers of water. And I will grow fruits. Then you will see what I was doing in the church. Then you will see why I'm Saturday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday in the church. That's why you will see why I'm attending every meeting that is in the church. That's why you will see where I'm reading Bible so much, because I am right now not buried. I am planted and I will grow. I am planted and I will grow. Amen. Praise God. Does it make sense to you guys? Are you ready for a little bit more? Okay, praise God. One more thing about planting. Praise God. Be with me. Oh, be with me. Just think about this. The bigger the tree, longer the seed remains inside the soil. Have you noticed that? Isn't it? Rashmi Bhai has gifted me limdo. Isn't it? Lovely. That limdo, you know how big it grows. But how, Rashmi Bhai, tame ketla vakat grow kare before you gave it to me? 4 years. And you know how big that limdo in my house is? This much. You know? Sometimes you think, you know, God, I'm here, I'm serving, I'm available, I'm doing healthcare, I'm tithing, I'm praying, I'm fasting, I'm doing everything. What is happening right now into my life? I want to tell you, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The seed requires longer to grow because seed does not have a short shelf life. Tree does not have a short shelf life. The tree is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. It's going to have a longer impact than a small rose bushes. Are we there? Isn't it? Praise God. Let me tell you, number one, we need to be planted. We need to be ready to undergo the transformation while we are being planted inside the soil. And third thing, we should be ready to wait while God does what He wants us to do into our lives. Are we willing to do that? Are we willing to give God that time into our lives? Say, you know, God, I am ready to grind. I'm ready to grind, you know, I'm ready to grind. I'm going to put up those hours. I'm going to read my Bible. I'm going to pray. I'm going to fast. I'm going to speak in tongues. I'm going to worship. I'm going to do everything I do because I want to grow fruits. I want to grow in a tree that will glorify God. And not only I will eat that fruit, but the generations that will come after me, they will eat the fruit from the trees that has come out of my hard work and my labor. Amen. That's about the tree. Bigger tree will have generational impacts. Are we there? Generational impacts. Let me tell you, each one of you are sitting here, you know, and I'm just saying, God can use each one of us to make that long-lasting impact. Hallelujah, praise God. Are we willing to get planted? Are we willing to undergo that transformation under the soil? Are we willing to remain in that dark room or dark soil where changes happen? God breaks us. God transforms us. God makes us uneasy, uncomfortable. Fasting is no fun, isn't it? I tell you, fasting is no fun, isn't it? By the time 2 o'clock, you get, you know, I'm just saying your stomach aches. Isn't it? It's no fun. But I'm saying we are not here for fun, isn't it? Praise God. I want to tell you, it's worth putting those grind because that grind will produce the growth. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. You don't seem excited. All right, 3 people. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, when you're planted, it's a holy quarantine. We all loved quarantine, you know? The quarantine always worked, has worked. We have put on some weight, isn't it? Isn't it? When you're planted by God, I'm saying that's a holy God. See, this, be with me, praise God. Are we willing to step into private before God makes us public? Everybody wants public thing, isn't it? Like it's a limelight thing, isn't it? But I want to tell you, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Jesus died publicly. Died publicly, everybody to saw. But when he rose up again, he showed to disciples privately. Be with me. So when disciples saw him privately, that power made them compelled to speak the name of Jesus publicly. What happened privately impacted their life publicly. If Jesus wouldn't have appeared to them privately, they wouldn't be effective publicly. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you, hallelujah, praise God. What happens in your life behind closed doors, hallelujah, that will determine what you will see when the doors are open. Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you. Under the soil, that is behind closed doors. Hallelujah, praise God. Closed doors represent private. Planting represents private life. What you do in privacy will determine what will you do for in public spheres. Are we there? You know, Pastor Satish is the funniest preacher I've ever met. And he used to, you know, funny practical jokes. He says, if you give somebody a prayer for food and if they pray for 10 minutes, it means they have not prayed at home at all. બધી પ્રાર્થના અત્યારે જ નીકળી ગઈ બધી વાર બીકોઝ દે નોટ પ્રેડ બિફોર ઇઝ સો આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ટેલ યુ વોટ હેપન્સ ઇન અ પ્રાઇવેટ લાઈફ વિલ ઇમ્પેક્ટ અવર પબ્લિક લાઈફ ઇઝ ઇટ પ્રેઝ ગોડ આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ ટેલ યુ ઇફ યુ કમ ટુ વર્શિપ મેક શ્યોર યુ કેમ વિથ વર્શિપ યુ કેમ ચર્ચ વર્શિપિંગ ઇઝ ઇટ યુ ગોટ અપ વિથ અ વર્શિપ ઇઝ ઇટ ઇફ યુ આર પ્રેઇંગ ઇન ધ ચર્ચ મેક શ્યોર યુ હેવ કમ પ્રેડ Isn't it? If you're preaching in the church, make sure you've prayed and fasted and done everything at all. Isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So planting is important because planting is private life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Okay, I'm going to move forward. Thank you, Jesus. Fourth thing. Hallelujah. Growing is... Next slide. Okay. All right. Oh, wait. This is important. Okay, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. I can't miss this. Okay. જ્યારે બીને વાવવામાં આવે પ્રેઝ ગોડ વેન ધ સીડ ઇઝ પ્લાન્ટેડ એન્ડ ઇફ ઇટ ટેક્સ લોંગર સીડ ડઝ નોટ સે યુ નો શૈલેષભાઈ ત્યાં મજા નહીં લેટ મી ગો ટુ રશ્મિભાઈ હાઉસ સીડ રિમેન્સ પ્લાન્ટેડ વેર ઇટ ઇઝ પ્લાન્ટેડ સીડ રિમેન્સ પ્લાન્ટેડ સીડ ડઝ નોટ જમ્પ ફ્રોમ વન પ્લેસ ટુ સીડ ડઝ નોટ સ્ટાર્ટ ક્વેશ્ચનિંગ હાઉ લોંગ નો પ્લાન્ટિંગ ટાઈમ Seed does not get afraid if it is too hot or too much rain. Are we there? Yes. Hallelujah. This is what happens to seed, isn't it? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, let's go to the next slide now. Fourth point, hallelujah. Growing is possessing the promise. Growing is possessing the? Possessing the. We all like promises, isn't it? Praise God. We all like promises, isn't it? We are pinky and we are promise. Okay. All right. Possessing the promise. Okay, praise God. Let's open Exodus chapter 6, verse 2 to 4. And God said to Moses, I am Yahweh the Lord, appeared to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, and as El Shaddai God, Almighty. But I did not reveal my name Yahweh to them, but I reaffirmed my covenant with them. Under its terms, I promised to give them, be with me, I promised to give them the land of Canaan where they were foreigners. Prabhu Musa nam keke me Ibrahim Isaac ne Jacob ne promise karyu che ke hu emne promised land apis. Are we there? Okay, let's fast forward to Joshua. Joshua chapter 1. Is it? Right? Thank you, Jesus. Joshua chapter 1 verse 2 and 3. And God said to Moses, I am Yahweh the Lord, appeared to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Is it the same verse? Okay, yeah, same verse. Is it? Okay, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, it was a different verse, but that's okay. That's okay. All right, get to the next slide. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Now be with me. Praise God. God promised them the land. Do you agree with me? God not only promised with them, God sent Moses to brought them out. Are we there? Praise God. God also brought them to this mountain and asked Moses to see the land from far. Are we there? You see? Praise God. But when they came to the land, right by the river Jordan, God says, listen to me very carefully. Listen to me very carefully. God says, now you cross Jordan. God, you're going to give the land. He said, no, I brought you here. That's your promise. Who's going to cross the Jordan? You cross the Jordan. Are we there? We're still waiting at Jordan. My promise is right there. You cross the Jordan, isn't it? Praise God. My Bible says, Joshua took all the land. Be very careful. God promised the land, Joshua possessed the land. Be with me. Praise God. Imagine. એવું ના થયું કે વેન પ્રભુએ એમને કીધું કે ચલો તમે લોકો આવો, વેન યુ એન્ટર આઈ વિલ ટેલ પેરાઝાઇટ્સ ગો આઉટ, ઝીવાઇટ્સ ગો આઉટ, જેબ્યુઝાઇટ ગો આઉટ, દે વિલ ઓલ ગો આઉટ, યુ ગો સ્ટાર્ટ લિવિંગ. ડીડ ગોડ સે દેટ? ગોડ સેઝ યુ ગો દેર, યુ ગો ઇન માય નેમ, દે વિલ બી સ્કેર્ડ ઓફ યુ, યુ ફાઇટ ધ બેટલ, આઈ વિલ મેક યુ વિક્ટોરિયસ એન્ડ યુ પઝેસ ધ લેન્ડ. આર વી દેર? Praise God. See, it's good to remember the promise of God. But what happens? We just remember the promise of God. We look at the promise of God from far. And we are waiting for promise to come to us. Come to? Promised land, come to me. God says, no, you go to? Not only you go to promised land, you possess the promised land. You will fight the war. You will get ready for the battle. You're going to blow the trumpet around the Jericho. You will put in some grind so that you will possess what God has already promised to you. Amen. Amen. Let me tell you one more thing, isn't it? Praise God. It was not Joshua's might that made him victorious over the promised land. God had already made him victorious. It was Joshua's faith, Joshua's action, Joshua's generation who fight the battle that made them victorious, because they were ready to possess what God has promised. They were ready to possess what God has promised. Hallelujah. Praise God. Are we there? God has promised a lot of things to you and me. And we have not received that promise. It's not because God has not fulfilled his promise. પ્રભુએ આપણને બહુ જ બધા પ્રોમિસીસ કર્યા છે અને પ્રોમિસ આપણા જીવનમાં ફૂલફિલ થયા નથી. એનું કારણ એ નથી કે પ્રભુએ આપણને ફૂલફિલ નથી કરી દીધા. એનું કારણ ફક્ત એ છે કે આપણે યર્દનની પાર ઉભા રહીને આપણે પ્રોમિસને જોયા રાખ્યું છે. We are not going to possess it. We are not, are we there? I know it's first session, and I get it. I'm not being hard, I'm just being honest. Are we there? I love you all, you know, praise God. Today's dinner on me. I can say that. All of you. Just look how it looks, unlimited. Praise God. Second be sadai, okay. That's it, okay. All right, coming back to that point. Are we willing to receive that promise into our lives? I'm talking to you. Are we willing to go that step and take that blessing into our life? You know, are we gonna fight our battles? Are we gonna wage the war? Are we gonna do the spiritual warfare? Are we gonna, you know, stand up and say, you know, I know fasting is hard, but I'm gonna fast. Praying is hard, but I'm gonna pray. Bible reading is hard, but I'm gonna read. You know, worshiping hard, but I'm gonna do that. All those things are gonna be hard. But I will do that, because not only I just want to keep looking at the promises, but I want to have the promise possessed. Are we there? Okay. Can I say something else? Okay. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes what we do, we see the promise. Durthi promise joy. Then promise is there, we run here. I want that God. God said promise is there. But I'm running this way. I'm running that way. Shilev koi orkhan chhe dost? I want that promise. Isn't it? Am I true or not? Just tell me, please. You know, dad ke chakkar chalao, I want that thing. Isn't it? God says, you know what? I have made you more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. Somebody believe, do you believe you are more than conquerors? You know? I don't care what you feel, because let me know, your feeling does not dictate the word of God. Word of God says you are more than conquerors. So if you don't feel, start feeling like more than conquerors, because God has said it and that's what you are. Hallelujah, praise God. So when we are more than conquerors, hallelujah, praise God, we can go and possess the land. Hallelujah, praise God. We don't have to be afraid. We don't have to be scared. We just have to go get that promise, what God has given to us. We are ready to fight that fight. We are ready to put that battle. Isn't it? Praise God. The last words I want to say that. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. The Danites, you know, Manasseh and Dan nu kud, adi kud, peli baju rahi gaya Jordan, because they wanted land there. God said, okay, give it to them. Now listen to the last verse. But Danite had difficulty taking possession. Any pelani verse. Manasseh were not able to occupy these towns. God has promised them. What happened? Just imagine. God has already told them this belongs to you. They could not take it for themselves. Isn't it? And the Bible, if you go, says Bible says those people remain in the land and they become snare to them. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Growing is possessing your promise. Somebody say, growing is possessing my promise. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's go. Let's go next. Okay, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I'm gonna close soon, okay? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Growing is stepping into your stepping. Somebody says stepping into your calling. Isn't it? Praise God. When I specifically chose this word stepping in, because it sounds like a slow process, just one step in. Isn't it? Praise God. Growing is stepping into your calling. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you. I want to tell you, praise God, growth is measured. Hallelujah. Let's read this verse, Hebrews chapter 11. Isn't it? Praise God. Hebrews chapter 11, 24, 25. We know this verse. Hallelujah. Praise God. And ultima lakoma vijay. Hebrew lakoma patra, agyarmadai. It was by faith Moses. Somebody say, when he grew up. Okay. When you grow up, that's when you do this. If you don't grow up, then you don't do this. Are you there? When he grew up, then he refused to be called the Pharaoh's daughter's son. Isn't it? Jare moto thayo, tyare ene Pharaoh's dikri no putra kevani na padi. He said, no, I'm not this. Let me know, when he was little, he didn't do that. Are you understanding? When you're a baby Christian, you may not be able to say the things of the past, that this is not who I am. I'm a child of God. But when you grow up, not only you will know that, but you also say that. He says, you know what? I'm not this. I'm not that. I'm not this. I'm a child of God. I'm a prized possession. I'm apple of God's eyes. I'm God's bride. I'm God's building. I am God's, whatever I am. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to say no to the things. No to the things. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. So number one thing, Moses, to step into his calling, he has to say no to some things. To step into his calling, before he become a deliverer, he has to say that I'm not Pharaoh's daughter's son. Are we there? See, the challenge is we want everything. We want this and we want that as well. Is that praise God? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I'm from Ahmedabad, okay? And Ahmedabad, there are. If you're in certain part of the city, you see a lot of bridges in Ahmedabad. Is that Nehru Bridge, Lakkadia Pool, Ellis Bridge, Gandhi Bridge? You see all the bridges. And most of the bridges separates old city from the new city. Like I lived in Shahpur, Kanpur. Isn't it? So if you are on this side of Nehru Bridge, kau theater to bhuli gaya, huh? नाना बोलो थिएटर रूपाली लाल दरवाजा पास दैट्स एन ओल्ड सिटी बी विद मी प्रेज गॉड बी विद दैट्स एन ओल्ड सिटी बट व्हेन आई गो ओवर द नेहरू ब्रिज आई एम ऑन गांधी रोड इट्स ए न्यू सिटी आर वी देयर व्हेन आई एम ग्रोइंग इन द व्हेन आई एम वॉकिंग थ्रू दैट ब्रिज एंड आई एम एंटरिंग द न्यू सिटी आई कैन ब्रिंग द ओल्ड सिटी विद मी द ओल्ड सिटी सेज आई एम गोइंग टू द Are we there? Okay. Which means if I need to be in new city, I need to let go of old cities. I need to go, I have to forget the restaurants in the old cities. I need to forget the movie theaters in old cities. I need to forget the hangout joints in old cities. Because I'm going to a new city. Are we there? Okay, praise God. So when I'm stepping into calling, I'm going in a new direction, I'm growing, I'm going to the new city, I'm going to the new calling, I'm going to a new purpose, new direction, new vision, new desire, everything new, I'm going there. When I'm going there, I can't bring old thing with me. I need to give that away. Let me tell you, I'm going to say that. I may have to give some people in old city, I have to let them go. Anybody? Yes. I have to let them go. Because they're not going to come. I'm going to let them go. Some of the things that I enjoyed in the old city, I'm going to let it go. Whatever that was there in the old city that was attracting me, that was almost binding me, I was very happy about certain things in the old city, I would let it go so that I can go to the new city. Praise God. Growing up is, You're stepping into the calling, putting old things on the side, entering the new plan and purpose in your life. Let me tell you, growing is taking the first step from that old city to new city. Are we there? I'm not going to sit in the old city and say, hey, I'm growing. You're not growing, you're just not moving there, isn't it? No, I have to take the first step. I'm approaching Nehru Bridge. Is it? Then I have to start walking and eventually I will reach on the other side. Praise God. I want to encourage my brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. To measure the growth, we need to measure how far or how near to what our calling is. Are we there? How far? God has called you to worship. You're part in worship team or whatever. I'm just a media team or whatever. I'm just going to give you an example. I'm going to pick on media team. I can pick on them and they can't even leave my house. Okay, I'm going to pick on Jimmy. Okay, praise. I say, Jimmy, you're doing this. And this is what God, this season of life, this is what you're going to serve God in Praise Bible Church. This is what you do. You know? You say, yeah, Pastor, I'll do it. He doesn't show up on time. Okay, if you are, you can't afford to not to show up on time. If he doesn't serve well, if he doesn't give 100%, if he say, you know, I you know, not this Sunday, Pastor, Amazon triple pay, not prime week going on. Let me tell you, he's not growing. The growing is not only he stepped into his calling, but now he's serving with all his heart, with all his mind, with all his desire. He's growing into his calling as well. I'm going to close in 2 minutes. Praise God. But as I close right now, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. It's very important for us to step into our calling, because calling is not something that is coming in the future. Calling is stepping into it right now. Right now. I didn't understand this, you know. And I foolishly said, God, I'm waiting. God says, you're waiting? I am waiting for you to move. You're waiting? Isn't it? God says, I am waiting. You're supposed to move. I told you 5 years ago. Praise God. I want to tell you, growing Christian is the Christian who is walking in his calling. I'm not saying that everybody will already reach their calling, but at least step into it. Amen? Are we there? Come on, a little bit smile, man. Please. I love you all again. Okay, praise God. So growing is will of God. Growing is personal commitment. Growing is, third point, anybody remember? Growing requires planting. Fourth is? Possessing the promise. And fifth thing, stepping into your calling. Now, after listening to the, how many you want to grow? Okay, listen to me, read the next verse. Okay, do you hear the verse? Okay, so 2 verses. He who gathers in summer is a wise son. Summer is the time of harvest. And when you harvest, when the time is there, it's a wise son. He who sleeps in the harvest is the son who causes shame. It means when God speaks to you, that's the right time. Okay? You're not waiting for the right time. When God speaks to you, that's the right time, because God knows what is the right time. And when it is the right time, you need to gather. If you gather, then you're wise. If you say tomorrow, or who sleeps in the harvest is a son who causes the shame. Okay? Are you getting what I'm saying? Okay, last verse for sure. I'm going to close after this. This verse says, but God will never forget the needy. I know context is money or resources, but I'm thinking need of any sort. Any need that you bring it to God, God will not forget it, because he's the provider. Are you there? When I was reading this verse, maybe almost 4 or 5 months ago, that's what the Spirit of God speak to my heart. And almost God asked me, God says, are you needy? And then I took a moment, I said, okay, I have food, my job is okay. And then almost that question come again, he says, are you needy? And the Spirit of God hit me and said, yes, Lord, I am needy. You know, I am needy. Can we have the next slide? Number one, I'm needy because I need you. That's why I'm needy. I'm needy because I need your spirit. I'm needy. What else I need? I need your presence. I need your grace. I need your voice. I need your anointing, Lord. I am needy. If you are needy of the growth, Bible says God will remember the needy. God will remember the needy. As long as we come with that expectation that, Lord, this is what I want. Okay? How about with that thing? Let's just close in prayer. Let's just close in prayer. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we want to say thank you, Father God. And Lord, we praise your holy name, Father God. Lord, because you're good. And your mercy endures forever. And as I pray, you know what? As I said, praying is, I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to God. So, you know, you can talk to God as well. Agree with me and add your words or add your prayer to it. Is that, you know, like show that commitment that you actually need to grow. Just raise up your arms or stand up and just say, Lord, you know what? I'm willing to put that grind. You know? No? Yeah. If you want to rise up, you know, show that commitment. Show that earnestness to God. Lord, yes, Lord, I want to grow. Is that, Lord, I know that you know, I failed in my commitment to grow. You know, I've been sitting there for 38 years. I've not even moved an inch. And Lord, I'm willing to pick up my mat and walk. Lord, I want to pick up whatever I was lying on, whatever I was comfortable with. I want to pick it up and not go to my comfort zone back again, Father God. Lord, I pray, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that I come myself, hallelujah, praise God. I pray, Father God, whatever has made me comfortable and kept me far from your promise, Father God, I pick it up right now and walk in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. And Lord, promises that you have promised to me, and Father God, if I have not possessed it, I am not possessed it, Father God, I pray in Jesus' name, I will have strength and courage to walk in that position, Father God. I pray that my lifestyle will change from this day onward. Lord, I pray in Jesus' name, the enemy of the procrastination be defeated today, right now, in Jesus' name, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you. We are not waiting for something to come, Father God, but we walk in the holy conviction and the power of the Holy Spirit to walk into that change from today onwards, Father God. Lord, I pray, Father God, hallelujah, Lord. Thank you. We lift up our arms and say, Lord, we want to grow, Lord. Lord, we want to grow in you, my Lord. We want to grow, hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, so we'll be transformed in your image. We want to stay where we are, Father God. We want to take a next step in your growth, Father God. So we ask, Holy Spirit, hallelujah, Lord, help us, oh my Lord. Empower us, oh Lord. Strengthen us, oh my Lord. Move us, oh my Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, is my prayer right now. Lord, I pray for all those people, hallelujah, who are waiting here for your touch, Father God, and to make that commitment to grow in you, Father God. Lord, you touch them right now in Jesus' name, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord, I pray, Father God, hallelujah. You strengthen them, you empower them, Father God. You make them victorious in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. Lord, let them know there's a God in heaven, oh my Lord, who is their Father, who takes care of their needs, hallelujah. And I pray in Jesus' name, the power of the Holy Spirit will flow through their life right now in Jesus' name, Father God. Whatever has been binding them, old thing, old habits, old nature, old laziness, old whatever old is, Father God, old weaknesses, Father God, we proclaim it to be broken down in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God. We do not turn back to it, Father God, but we move ahead towards the destination that you have called us to be. Father God, today we choose to grow, Father God, and we pray, Father God, let your Holy Spirit, Lord, move, hallelujah, and make way for us, Father God, is my prayer right now. I pray in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God, hallelujah, Lord, as you grow us, Father God, hallelujah, I pray in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, Father God, whatever promise that you have promised to us, we are possessing it today, Father God. We are possessing our healing back today, Father God. We are no longer living under the curse of sickness, Father God. We are not allowing devil to bind us anymore in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. That the affliction of devil, we declare the devil defeated once again in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Those who are experiencing any kind of sickness, I want you to pray for yourself right now, hallelujah. Open your mouth loudly and pray to God. Pray to that sickness, pray to that organ. Tell that organ to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. If it is your knee, tell your knee, I command you to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Migraine, I command you to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Arthritis, hallelujah, I command you to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus. Sleep apnea, I command you to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Any flu, I command you to be healed in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I praise you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Lord, we possess that promises, Father God. And Lord, we step into that calling, Father God. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask, hallelujah, your Holy Spirit continue to move with us. Convict us, grow us, Help us to move in the direction that you have called us to be, Father God. I pray and seal this word in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. I will not allow enemy to steal it anymore, my Lord. But we burn it into our heart, Father God, so that it will bring forth fruit for your glory alone, Father God. Is my prayer right now, Father God. Lord, we surrender ourselves, Father God. And we pray in Jesus' name by faith that we will see that growth into our life before this camp gets over, oh my Lord. We will see, hallelujah, the transformation happening from Thursday to Sunday in Jesus' name, oh my Lord. Your voice will be clearer from today to Sunday. Your word will be clearer, Father God. Your Holy Spirit will be louder, oh my Lord. We'll be empowered from today to Sunday, Father God, because your will be done into our life and your will for us to grow in Jesus' name, Father God. We put away old things, Father God. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. The newness of the Holy Spirit help us to propel us into the destiny and the purpose that you called us to be, Father God. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory, all the honor, Father God. We trust you for your promise. We believe you at your word, and we are ready to take action for our own personal growth. We seal it in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. In the highest name of God, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You may be seated. May God receive all the glory. Hallelujah. Praise God. And I pray this session will help you to come expectantly from tomorrow's session as well. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Go with this question. You can go to your group. Spend next 10 minutes. Hallelujah. And talk to one another. And as we have decided, if you don't remember your group number, there's a paper right there at the wall. Check where your name is. We're going to start with group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, group 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and we can group 10. If you want to sit, sit. If you want to stand, you can have a small stand-up meeting as well. Take next 10 minutes and do so. Is that right? Group 1 can come here. I'm standing right here, group 1. Okay. And group 10 can go right the other side. Praise God. Take time. Those who have come, Jordan, better just check your group and just be in your group wherever it is, and then you will know what to do. One. Somebody from two? Anybody from two? You from two? Shout number two here. Two here. Number three, conscious. Somebody shout number three. Okay.